Someone had told me back when I was 10 years old that when I grow up, I would design experiences for futuristic cities, flying cars, hypersonic trains, and autonomous vehicles. I would have not believed it. At that time, those dreams only existed in my sketchbooks. Hello, my name is Fede Ponce, founder of Ronin X Design, a design firm offering next generation user experiences for the mobility industry. In a way, I am still that 10-year-old kid who has a positive and perhaps naive outlook about the future of humanity. I am motivated by gratitude, and I cannot believe that every day I get to pick apart complex problems to find human-centered solutions. I am incredibly passionate about bringing to life products found in the intersection of data, design, tech, well-being, and sustainability. Today, I would love to talk to you about a future that is forming right in front of our very eyes, some of its challenges, and of course, its opportunities. I am currently working with some of the top OEMs around the world, figuring out what the future holds. And the main question I always get is, how can I be different in the age of autonomous vehicles and alternative energy sources? How can we compete in a market where most major trends point toward less use of a personal car? My answer is relatively simple. The new generation of users is not interested in hardware. They're interested in experiences, consuming, creating, and sharing them. Experience has become the ultimate social currency. Today, users have a window into anything they can desire through their smartphone device. However, smartphones are flat windows providing a two-dimensional experience. Vehicles, however, are the next smart device and a moving portal to a brand new world of fourth-dimensional experiences. In fact, autonomous vehicles will bring about the largest paradigm shift in mobility, from public-private transportation to mobile extensions of one's own home. Already, we see a massive transformation in the way we think about cars. We began our journey in mobility as machine operators, but now we will become what I call the bubble passengers. This is taking some time to adapt to, but the biggest chasm for most companies right now is understanding that a piece of hardware can be iterative, meaning it can evolve via software, but also hardware updates. Cars can be upgraded over the air, not just for performance, but for security, and of course, entertainment. And so today, a car is no longer on a path of being solely a machine. It is on the path to become the next smart device. Now, if you don't believe me, recently a hacking race has been brought to light where users began unlocking features on their Teslas. And so the car manufacturer has responded. And now it has shifted to not just being a hardware manufacturer, but also a cybersecurity firm. And that's just the beginning. The manufacturer of the future might be able to tap into a user's social media feeds, with permission, of course, and use machine learning algorithms to create the ultimate top hat space based on specific user needs. Now that top hat can be 3D printed and then placed on a mass manufactured electric skateboard. This is not science fiction, this is today. Companies like Local Motors have successfully 3D printed entire fleets of autonomous vehicles and have even conducted crowdsourced design competitions. Once we understand this paradigm, then we must ask ourselves, how will we interact with these new devices? And what are the market opportunities for digital ecosystems within them? Currently, the initial HMI trends point us to minimalism and over-reliance on screens. This has been our first solution as designers. We're kind of just replacing the mobile experience and bringing that into the vehicles. And to be honest, it's been a little bit awkward. Most of the design focus has been around transferring what was once physical input into digital one. But this is only one solution and one point of view. In fact, personally, I find it lacking and not truly human-centered. In the exploration of future experiences, we must consider all the possible ranges of human input. Touch, sound, vision, and even our own emotions and faces can become input. We also need to consider context. Where is the user going? Why is the user utilizing this space? Is it for privacy or is it for health reasons? Is the user going to a meeting or to a football game? Or is the user going to a romantic date? Does the user own the vehicle or is the vehicle part of a subscription service? If the vehicle is private, does it become an adjacent room in the home? Or maybe an in-home office space? What is the importance of digital customization and secure universal profiles? In a post-COVID global warming reality, what role does transport, health, and sanitation play? What we thought was coming 15 years into the future has actually been accelerated by the global pandemic. Our ideas of space have changed dramatically, and the need for digital transformation has caught many companies off guard. I know it all seems like a lot, but that is what next generation experience designers need to think about. Our thinking and problem solving approach is holistic. We do not just look at a screen as part of a digital solution. We have to look at the entire context, the digital ecosystem, the user behavior, and of course, social impact and sustainability. The next logical step is integration and harmonization with smart cities and smart commerce. Picture the following scenario. Could an autonomous vehicle serve as a classroom for education? Real-time graphics rendering, LiDAR, digital twin cities, and motion tracking could take school buses out of this world and directly to Mars. What about sports store of the future? Could companies sync autonomous drones to deliver custom-grown biodegradable cleats right into a soccer field? Or right into an autonomous vehicle in motion? The answer to all of this is yes. And the even more exciting answer is that all these interactions will need an interface. The question is, will interfaces of the future be screens or something else? And what will define these experiences? And this is why today it's so important that I tell you we must think beyond the screen. That's why a next generation product begins with understanding a system, an entire system, having empathy for participants, followed by disruption of said system with a clear collateral impact analysis. It then continues with innovation as the initial state of a solution, but finalizes with harmonization. The cycle then repeats each time, improving itself while respecting all the active players in the ecosystem involved. The reason I say that is because so far we've seen a lot of disruption without innovation, and a lot of innovation without harmonization. That is why our biggest challenge as designers is not to change technology. It is to change minds in a way that creates platforms for collective success. Contact me if you have questions about next-gen product design cycles and the future of user experience. I hope to see you in the near future.